Welcome to the history of ECW. I am Taz, and guess what? We got a theme for you today. Our crack staff here, our crack production staff, come up with a theme. The theme is classic rematches. But they're not that old, even though they're classic. They're kind of cool, but they're classic in regards to, like, ECW history. For example, we're going to have an ECW championship rematch. The champion, the Sandman, defends his title versus Cactus Jack, and get this little wrinkle. The special guest referee is none other than former ECW champion, the franchise, Shane Douglas, the supposed buddy, the supposed friend, the supposed Goomba of Cactus Jack. We'll see how that thing unfolds. Going into another classic rematch, Raven, Tommy Dreamer. God, does it get any more extreme, any more hardcore, any more violent? These two cats are going to go at it in an extreme death match right here in this episode. You're not going to want to miss that. Trust me, I was there. I saw it off the chain. And then another rematch. A little different, though. A classic technical rematch, or maybe I should say a technical classic rematch, or any way you want to word it. I would word it wrongly, but who's counting? The late, great Eddie Guerrero, Dean Malenko. These two battled all over the United States for ECW in this great rivalry. Classic, classic, technical, amazing stuff you're going to see with Guerrero and Malenko. Enough of me telling you about it. Let's check it out.
Hostile City Showdown is history and available on ECW Home Video. During that historic night of wrestling action, Eddie Guerrero faced Dean Malenko, defending his ECW television title. The matchup went to a 30-minute time limit draw. Just a few nights ago at the ECW Arena, the much-anticipated rematch, once again, a 30-minute time limit draw. This weekend, 24 hours, three cities, 2 days, one match. The Malenko Guerrero Classic, available only from ECW. This weekend, live!
Welcome to Extreme Championship Wrestling. I'm Joey Styles, and we are in Tampa, Florida. And as you can hear, the ECW is taking the Sunshine State to the extreme. The situation between ECW television champion Eddie Guerrero and the shooter Dean Malenko continues this weekend over the course of 2 days in three different cities. It's 2 out of 3 falls as Guerrero defends the television title once again against the shooter Dean Malenko. On tonight's program, Tommy Dreamer gets his wish. It's the matchup he demanded. It's an extreme death match as he will go one-on-one with Raven. And before we let you in on tonight's television main event, perhaps we should go to last week's edition of Extreme Championship Wrestling.
You and I have been friends for a long time, brother, but there's no reason for you tonight to be taking my world title shot for my heavyweight title. Now, the way I see it, Cactus Jack, you can do one of two things. You can be a man and back out of this match and give your friend exactly what's rightfully his, and that's the title shot, or you can go through my dead body for that title.
Shane Douglas, whichever way you want it, you've got it, because I guarantee you, if you don't get out of my way, I will remove you, because one way or another, I'm the man who's got the title shot, Shane. I didn't want one, but I deserve it.
That's it. That's it, goddammit.
Hold my watch, Chris.
You!
Cactus has the sleeper locked on with the chain around the throat of the Sandman as well. And the Sandman is going out. If that hand comes down twice more, we've got a new World Heavyweight Champion. One more time, and we've got a new champion. Cactus Jack will be the new champion. Here it comes. Even just knocked the referee cold with a Singapore cane. The Sandman was out. Here come the Shooter and the Crippler. They're attacking Cactus Jack. The Sandman is out cold. You can bet the franchise had something to do with this. Malenko and Benoit knocked Cactus cold with a Singapore cane and a powerbomb. Woman put Sam on top of Cactus too. Oh no, oh my.
You son of a bitch. You cost me the belt!
Wait a second, Cactus. You and I have gone at a Cactus Jack long enough. And I'm gonna tell you, I never laid a hand on you. I never touched you.
Well, what's stopping you now, Shane? What's stopping you now?
This Saturday night, Cactus Jack, you have no idea. You have no idea how easy it's gonna be for me to become the world's heavyweight champion again.
Oh, gentlemen, it's not gonna be as easy as you think.
Tonight, right here from Tampa, Florida, woman who turned on the franchise, Shane Douglas, managing the World Heavyweight Champion, the Sandman who stole that title from the franchise, Shane Douglas, the special guest referee, Douglas himself. Shane Douglas, the former champion who claims the rules are too lax here in Extreme Championship Wrestling and that we would all be better off in the WWE. God help us. Douglas will be the special guest referee tonight as the Sandman defends the World Heavyweight Championship against my guest at this time, the challenger, Cactus Jack.
Joey, don't you think you're being just a little bit too hard on the franchise? Can't you see that the franchise, a man with a broken heart? Put yourself in his place. Haven't you ever had your heart broken? Now I'm the man who goes out there in just a few short minutes to achieve my destiny as a heavyweight champion of the world, but I can't help to think of Shane Douglas a broken man. And despite what he may have said about his addiction to women, I happen to know what broke Shane's heart was not a woman, was not a female being, it was the belt. You see, Shane, you don't have a weakness for the women, although you might like the world to think so. You've got a weakness for the gold. That little symbol that tells you you are an important man in this world, Shane, that you're not a mid-card wrestler. Well, I'll stand here right now and I'll tell you you're not a mid-card wrestler. What you are right now is the link in my journey to the heavyweight championship of the world. And Shane, I gotta face the fact that you are a man with an obsession for that belt that makes O.J. Simpson look like a matrimonial philanthropist. So Shane, you don't look at Cactus Jack and say, hey, my best friend is on his way to fulfill his destiny. You look at it like, hey, my best friend's trying to nail my old girl and he might do it better than me. Well, Shane, snap out of it and call this one down the line, or I'll send you down the line on a very rocky road to Stanford. Bang, bang!
There you have it from the challenger, Cactus Jack. Tonight, it's our television main event. A very excitable Cactus Jack in his quest to become the new ECW World Heavyweight Champion will have to run through the Sandman, keep his eye on woman, and be leery of the special guest referee, what one time was his best friend, the former World Heavyweight Champion, the franchise, Shane Douglas.
That some punk that I've known since I'm 12 years old won't get out of my life. I can't get my hand raised, no matter how much I beat his ass.
Tommy Dreamer, who has fought so hard to achieve respect as a hardcore wrestler, cannot go on with his career. He is obsessed with beating Raven, who is in the ring right now. And Raven attacks Dreamer. He's not waiting for the bell. Raven all over Dreamer. Steel chair across the back. Raven whipped in hard. Face first onto the concrete floor. Dreamer's got a baking sheet. And the innovator of violence goes to work on his arch nemesis. We've seen this before. Tommy Dreamer will assault Raven with anything he can get his hands on. Dreamer is obsessed with beating Raven. Dreamer's got a skillet, and the violence escalates as ECW takes Florida to the extreme, and Raven goes downstairs. Raven stomps Dreamer. And Dreamer gets driven throat first across that steel guardrail. Nowhere to go. There's no give. Raven and Dreamer heading towards the back wall. Face first into the wall. Dreamer's in trouble. And Raven is unrelenting. Tommy Dreamer seeking refuge up in the bleachers. Raven right out after him. Face first. Busted open. I don't like the looks of this. Trying to get Dreamer up for a pile driver. No, back body drop. Thank heaven Dreamer escaped that. That would have been all for Dreamer. Chair across the back. And now Tommy Dreamer is on the attack. Raven back to ringside, courtesy of Dreamer.
My brother, hit him.
Oh, my. A license plate between the eyes. And the fans quick to hand Tommy Dreamer anything that he can get his hands on in his quest to beat Raven. Remember, this is an extreme death match. A winner will be crowned by pinfall or submission only. Dreamer reaches for the house mic. And no comment by Raven. And I will abstain as well. Richard's none too happy about the beating his hero is taking at the hands of Dreamer. Raven's thrown in hard to that steel guardrail. Oh! Dreamer's got a cheese grater! Dreamer is obsessed with destroying Raven. Weaver head first into the table. Concerned look on the face of Pula McGillicuddy. Suplex on the outside. One of the fans handed Dreamer a cheese grater. I don't believe Raven sees it. Tommy goes face first into the ring apron. Dreamer whipped in. Raven ducked his head just a second too soon. Now Dreamer picks up the cheese grater. I don't know what to say. And neither does Raven, unless it's in Soprano. Dreamer now with his choice of weapons, courtesy of the great fans here in Florida, goes with the old standby, the steel chair, and his pet finisher, the DDT. Richards up on the apron, but not for long. Cover! One, two, and no! Richards got clocked by Dreamer, but it gave Raven just enough time to survive the DDT. Dreamer now opening up on Raven. And those overhand rights by Tommy Dreamer are as powerful as any punches you'll see in this sport. Raven runs into the boot. And power slams Dreamer on the chair. Oh, no, no, no. Raven gets the two. And would you look at this goofball? God, do I miss Jason. And my hives are coming back. Lady Luck was definitely on Raven's side tonight. Richard just spit at Dreamer. He must be crazy. Oh, did he just make a mistake? DDT. DDT on the referee. That only leaves one person. Boy, some people just never learn. Beulah just slapped Dreamer. Gloria Steinem, this one's for you. Good night, Beulah McGillicuddy. Raven with the chair. DDT. That tough guy, Richards. Tommy Dreamer now firing back on Richards and Raven. It's 2-on-1. But Dreamer, wait, that's Luna. That's Luna Vachon. Luna's in there. She's beating the snot out of Steve Richards. Breaking the back of Richards. That's Luna Vachon. Luna Vachon is here. What is Luna doing here? Are you kidding me? The war between Dreamer and Raven continues. But what the hell does Luna have to do with any of this?
Paul had allowed myself and Raven a lot of creative freedom, which is a blessing. because a lot of times you're just told, this is what you have to do. Here's someone telling you, what do you want to do? What? And it was great because it worked. For the simple fact of, I never beat him. And every time I'd come so close, I would somehow just not pull it off. The feud between me and Raven came also at a great time. We had these amazing wrestlers who were putting on great wrestling matches. Chris Benoit, Eddie Guerrero, Dean Malenko, and Taz. We were being known as a wrestling company. And then a feud came in, a violent, violent feud. So now you have great wrestling and a great violent feud. So many things spurned off of that, and so many people's lives were affected by it.
Welcome back to Expo Park here in Tampa, Florida. And this place has just erupted after what we have just seen. And standing by right now in the basement of this very building, Dreamer and Luna.
And yet another chapter in the ongoing saga known as Dreamer and Raven continues. See, the flesh is weak, but the mind is strong. Raven, you've always been weak. I've seen fear in your eyes. I know now I can never escape our past, but now I have someone out of your past. She laid with the lepers, climbed the highest mountain of Tibet, and spoke to the man with the third eye, and was strapped to the tree of woe for 30 days. But most of all, she's always been hardcore.
Is there any yearnings? Quite as potent as rage. You see, I am the woman that has stood in the shadow and the strength of many warriors. And no longer will I stand behind them. But now, my dream is to stand beside him. Kyle! Wake up, Crow-Man! This is the rudeness! My rage will be your horror show! The injustices against Luna Vachon will be taken out! In the ECW, there will be no holding me back. I've always been a misfit. I never fit to your holes. But now, two misfits join together.
How frustrating for Tommy Dreamer. I mean, Tommy was just never able to get ahead of Raven, no matter what Tommy did, no matter how hard he wrestled in that match, or any match for that matter against Raven, no matter what happened, by hook or crook, at the end of the day, Raven ended up coming out on top somehow against Dreamer. Not for nothing, on a side note, how about that Luna, huh? She a looker or what? Smoking hot. I mean, you know, if you're into that kind of, you know, a human being that looks like that, you know, half a head shaved, some veins painted on the face, she got that voice like that. It's kind of sexy, you know? Give me a Taz, give me a kiss. I like that. I'm into that. It's getting weird and uncomfortable right now, but I kind of like that. Anyway, let's segue uncomfortably. ECW Championship match right now. Rematch. The Sandman is the champion. Cactus Jack is the challenger. The special guest referee, the franchise.
Rocco! Them pit bulls are so tough. They had us beat, Rocco. Oh, what happened?
Oh, Johnny, my back hurts. My neck hurts. My head hurts.
I don't know, Rocco. I think Lady Luck was on our side.
So strong.
I don't know what to do. Them pit bulls are so strong.
Public enemy!
That's right, baby. Lady Luck is not gonna be there for you next weekend, baby, because this weekend, three matches in a row, three different kinds of matches. And there is no way that we will leave those buildings without them belts, because baby, we are the next tag team champions, because we had you beat, and everybody in that arena seen it. Everybody in the ECW arena saw it. Public enemy, Lady Luck
will not be on your side. The Pitbulls will not be denied. The next ECW Badasses Tag Team Champions.
And a woman leads the ECW World Heavyweight Champion, as much as it pains me to say that, to the ring. And the Sandman enjoying his pre-match up stuff. It was right here in Tampa, Florida, that woman first made her impact in the sport of professional wrestling. Then the Fallen Angel, managing the likes of Kevin Sullivan, Mark Lewin, and a whole host of other sickly thugs who left their mark on the state of Florida. And tonight, she and the Sandman are gonna take Tampa to the extreme. Woman managing a World Heavyweight Champion for the third time. First it was Ric Flair, then the former ECW World Champion, the franchise, Shane Douglas, and now that man, the Sandman. But the Sandman is the first wrestler he led to the world title. Flair and Douglas were already champion when she began to manage them. She just loves that goal. She digs it. Maybe it's me. Am I the only one who's troubled by the fact that the Sandman represents Extreme Championship Wrestling right now? I mean, this guy got to where he is by smoking four packs a day and getting in ballroom brawls every night. And she got to where she is, but he got to where he is by smoking four packs a day and getting involved with every night. And he carried the Singapore cane.
The former World Heavyweight Champion, And the challenger, up until a couple of weeks ago, was Douglas's best friend. This is extremely interesting. Douglas with some words for woman. Can't quite hear him, but probably better for broadcast TV.
For the ECW World Heavyweight Championship. The special guest referee for this match is the former ECW Heavyweight Champion, the franchise, Shane Douglas! And introducing first in the ring, first the manager, Woman!
She is pure evil. Challenger. A man who, although he's only 29 years old, is destined to be a legend of this sport. And tonight, he goes after the one goal that has eluded him in his pilot. Headline-stealing career, the heavyweight championship of the world. Cactus Jack looks right at home here in Florida. By the look of intensity on Douglas's face, you'd think he was wrestling.
And ladies and gentlemen, the challenger from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico.
When we return, Cactus Jack challenges a Sandman for the World Heavyweight title. And the special guest referee, Jack's best friend, and the former World Heavyweight Champion, the franchise Shane Douglas. There's the bell, the World Heavyweight title is on the line. They're coming to you from Tampa, Florida. The Sandman defending the ECW World Heavyweight title against Cactus Jack. The franchise, Shane Douglas, former world champion, and Jack's best friend, the special guest referee. Douglas has already checked Jack for any foreign objects. Both men are clean, they locked up. Sandman backs the challenger to the corner. Sandman breaks before the count of five. A very fair count by the franchise, Shane Douglas, who claims he's going to crawl it down the middle. This time, Jack has Sandman back into the corner. Another fair count by Douglas, and Jack breaks before the count of five. Douglas has been complaining since getting into his first brawl with the Sandman that there are no rules here at Extreme Championship Wrestling, almost to the point of nausea. So tonight, Douglas taking matters into his own hands. He's gonna call it right down the middle. Jack now opens up on the Sandman with forearms. They are not close fists. And the Sandman is thrown to the outside. Cactus Jack looking out at the Sandman. Shane Douglas has started the 10 count. Into the guardrail goes the champion. Jack rolls back in to break up the count. Oh my! garbage can between the eyes. The franchise now admonishing Cactus Jack. With the chair between the eyes. And Douglas breaks it up. And the Sandman takes advantage. The challenger thrown back in the ring. The champion's got the Singapore cane, and Douglas cuts him off. Shane Douglas enforcing the rules just as he said he would. And the minute his back is turned, Cactus Jack opens up on the Sandman with a series of closed fists. Douglas telling Jack, use the open hand, adhere to the rules. Leg drop. Cover. One. One count only. Douglas asking the Sandman if he wants to give it up. Making sure it is not a choke. Douglas making the Sandman release a handful of hair. Douglas really calling it by the book. Go up to the franchise. Every match would be Dory Funk Jr. and Jack Briscoe from right here in Tampa 20 years ago. I mean, hey, who's not a fan of Eddie Guerrero versus Dean Malenko? But like the marquee says, we are Extreme Championship Wrestling. And that's what these fans here in Florida came to see. The Sandman rolls from the outside. Straight left hand. Douglas already up to four. Cactus rolls back in. The Sandman trying to drag him out. Headbutt by Cactus Jack. A second one. And a kick right to the chest. The Sandman retaliates. Jack whipped it. Well-placed back elbow. Douglas checking for blood. He wouldn't actually stop this match if there was some blood, would he? I mean, this isn't like Atlanta. Somebody bleeds, we don't throw him out of here and tell all the fans to go home. Woman now with the Singapore cane across the throat of Cactus. Few choice words for woman. Vertical suplex by the Sandman, nicely executed. And Cactus thrown to the outside again. Douglas telling the Sandman to keep the hands out of the hair. Douglas telling the Sandman to go to a neutral corner, putting the 10 count on Cactus Jack. The Sandman now with the throat of Cactus Jack across the bottom rope. There's the count by Douglas. And woman with the Singapore cane, Douglas never saw it. He surely would have disqualified the Sandman. Snapmare out of the corner. Douglas laying down the law, and again, woman raking the cane across the ear of Cactus Jack. And Douglas has ejected woman. He caught her. She's gone. She's history.
She's out of here.
You out of here now.
Douglas putting a countdown woman. And physically escorting woman towards the locker room. And the minute the franchise's back is turned. Cactus unloads with a chair. Well, while the cat's away, the mice will brawl. And I can't imagine Douglas is seeing any of this, or this matchup would be over. The Sandman unloads with that can. Jack with a well-placed forearm and a boot to the face. The champion thrown back in. Here comes Douglas. Now you didn't miss anything. Face first into the buckle goes the champion. Once again. The Sandman goes downstairs and we should all say no to them. Including myself. Douglas lost the contact, it seems, while something fishy's got cover. One, two, no! Two count only. Well, we hope Mr. Douglas has readjusted his contact lens. Cactus goes downstairs. Beautiful swinging neck breaker. Cover! Two? Oh, now wait, there was definitely hesitation on the third fall of the head. Well, judging from this crowd reaction, I'm not the only one who saw it. Jack going for a pile driver, it hits. The Sandman spiked. There's the cover. One, two, a cover! He got his shoulder up. I could too after 2 minutes. Well, Douglas is now abusing his power as an official. Double arm DDT. That's all. We've got a new champion. Come on. Count him down. Ah, oh, come on. What a hypocrite. Complains about no rules for a month and then pulls this, and Jack is not too happy. And who can blame him? Jack unloads on the Sandman. Straight forearms. Douglas counting Jack. Jack's ignoring. Franchise getting physical. And Jack just shoves him out of the way. Oh, come on. What? He ring the bell. For what? That was a quick count. Well, Douglas is disqualifying the Sandman. Douglas has stooped to an all-time low, and he has definitely learned how powerful, just how powerful, a referee can be. The Tampa X-Ball Hawk is gone berserk after what we have just witnessed. The franchise proving himself to be the biggest hypocrite of them all, taking full advantage of his assigned position as an official, disqualifying Cactus Jack, and now Douglas knows the true power of a referee. And Tampa, Florida knows the power of Extreme Championship Wrestling.
Tampa, Florida, ECW back in the day, couldn't get any better. I remember, I was having a ball, you kidding me? Chicks in bikinis, hot sunshine, driving around in a nice Yugo. It was awesome. It was phenomenal. Back, I loved it. I had a lot of fun in Tampa in ECW days. We all did. Even though I was kind of by myself, no one really hung out with me. And there's reasons for that. But speaking of reasons, I'd love a reason from Paul Heyman or Paulie Dangerously, whatever you want to call him, for not putting a little bit more to Tasmaniac in that little video package. One little blurb. If you blinked, you didn't see it. That's not cool at all. All right. Let's talk briefly about the franchise, Shane Douglas, his lack of ability to be a fair referee, because he basically screwed Cactus Jack from defeating the Sandman from getting the ECW championship. I'm sure we're going to find more out about this as the ECW deal here, as we motor on. This episode was phenomenal. We just did a whole deal on rematches, but classic rematches. None of mine in there, but again, who's counting? Look, I'm Taz, you're not. I had a lot of fun. I did a great job. You loved it. I know you did. I'll catch you next time. See you.